The Animal Welfare League on Sydney's Western Fringe is the home of Second Chances.
It's a little Australian terrier mix.
I don't even know what that is.
Here, dedicated staff and volunteers match the orphaned and abandoned with their forever families.
Hi.
Oh, hello.
Can't believe there's a crime.
And while sometimes it's a miss, there's no mistaking true love when it's strong. Straight to the heart.
My beautiful boy.
They love you.
Can I take you home?
All dogs have the same basic survival needs as humans: food, water, and shelter. But like us, they need so much more to really thrive.
Who do we have here?
This is Gigi.
Gigi.
And Olive.
Olive.
They need love, friendship, and kindness.
And we have kennels just inside.
Okay.
All right, well, we'll take these guys through.
They need that sense that even when things are bleak, they are safe and they are cared for.
And who do we have here today?
We have Chai and we have Pucci.
So what is the reason for surrender today?
My father-in-law is not feeling very well and he lives overseas, so we have to go there to look after him.
Yep.
And take the dogs with us. So
yeah. And how old is Chai?
Chai is 10.
Okay.
Pucci is 11.
Yep.
They've been together since we got them. So they love each other.
Oh, that's
best
cute.
Friends.
When a surrender comes in, we need to get the dog into a kennel, get it some water, some food, and really make it feel safe.
I love you.
Hey, Chai.
Hi, Pucci.
I love you.
Come here, darlings. It's okay. Come here.
It's all right.
Come here.
Good.
It's okay, you two. It's all right. It's okay.
What kind of dog do you think we'll get?
I don't know. Golden Retriever.
Oh, everybody wants one of those.
There's probably none left.
Their way to fulfill their long-held dream of owning a dog are the Stace family.
Hello.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good.
How are
Hello.
You guys?
Good.
When we were dating, it's always the key questions. What's your name? What's your favourite colour? Do you like dogs?
Who have we got here today?
Jack, Isla, Valentina and Zahra.
Oh, lovely to meet you.
I think we're all a bit kooky and very, very creative.
How are you, Valentina? Are you feeling excited?
Yeah, I'm really.
Yeah?
The first thing she said when she woke up, she was half asleep. Are you excited to get in?
I love dogs 100%. I like how they're surprising, like what they're going to do next.
Teeny!
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
How are you? Good, how are you?
Good, thanks.
Well, thank you.
And what are we here for today?
We're here to get
doggy.
Do we want something that's like extra goofy, or do we want something that's going to cuddle up at night?
I like the goofball dogs.
Yeah.
I like silly dogs.
Silly dogs.
Goofy and silly.
So a little dog or a big dog?
Well, cute dog.
Well, so this is the argument here.
Okay.
So Jack and I have always grown up with big dogs.
Right.
But the kids like a smaller, medium dog.
Okay.
But if they just know how lovable
and
they
cuddly,
are. Yeah.
It's just more dog to love, guys.
Yeah, pretty much.
If it is a bigger dog.
Big dogs are okay. It's just, it feels a bit weird having the dog bigger than the size we are.
Like, but you're going to grow, remember?
Hopefully I'll grow.
Hopefully you'll grow, yeah. And how are the kids with dogs?
At the start, they might be a bit more cautious.
Okay.
But once they see that calm side,
sure.
They'll warm up.
Awesome. Yeah. And why now?
It's not why now. It's now. Because
finally.
Yeah, it's finally.
Yeah.
Finally.
Well, we've just moved into our new house.
Our first home.
Yeah.
When Jack and I met, we instantly fell in love with the idea that we're both dog people. But unfortunately, that dream of having a dog never came. When we moved in together, it wasn't suitable for a dog. And then every sort of year and sometimes every 6 months we'd move house. When I was pregnant with Valentina, we needed a bigger space, so we moved. The lease was up, we moved again. So in total, I think we've moved
ten times.
10 times.
In 10 years.
So there's no other pets currently?
No.
This
will be our first as a family.
We've been waiting for our dog.
Waiting for your dog. Oh, that's lovely.
Okay, moving all the time like that, you lose a lot of friends. But now we finally have our own home. It's time for a dog. And for me, it'll be really nice to have that friend that's always there.
Look, guys, we'll be back with you pretty soon.
Thank you so much.
No worries. Yeah, all right.
Oh, I'm so excited.
Hello.
They are so cute.
These little girls.
Yeah. And two parents who love big dogs.
Yeah. Zahra and Jack, they love their big dogs.
Okay, cool. All right, that seems, what options are we looking at?
We do have a Maremma, Maggie. Ah,
look at that.
So Maggie is a 2.5-year-old female Maremma sheepdog. She's aloof with strangers but fiercely loyal to her owners. She takes time to warm up but can be playful with people and other dogs.
I think with Maggie, I think she'd be better with a lot older kids and probably more so on a property than a house as well, being a Maremma.
Yeah, I mean, she can be quite aloof at times, and I haven't quite befriended Maggie just yet. So not one that's going to come out and be okay with kids touching her and stuff like that.
We do have a beautiful Wolfie.
They want a dog who was
goofy and silly.
Goofy and silly, oh, Wolfie.
That's Wolfie.
Yeah.
So Wolfie is a 5-month-old Irish Wolfhound mixed breed, super energetic and wants to say hello to everyone he meets. He came to the shelter as a medical surrender and his owners could not afford vet treatment.
You know, when Wolfie came in, he was a positive parvo case, so, you know, he was on the edge of life, you know, nearly passed away.
Yeah. It's so hard, especially when a dog is as skinny as him that can't keep food down.
Can't keep anything down.
He's come a long way. We had a great vet team who saved his life, so that's really good, and he now needs to find a loving home.
The only thing with Wolfie, I think he's a great match. It'll just be whether he's too much for the little girls or not.
Yeah.
But it might just be one of those meet and greets that the handler might have to stay in for a little bit longer just to sort of give him some tips and tricks on how to deal with Wolfie, because if you get a snack out, he's on his bottom straight away.
Yeah. But I think, Wolfie's a great option.
And he's silly and he's goofy, which
that's
is
what they
want.
They
are.
Just
want
yeah.
Okay, Wolfie it is.
Yay. Okay.
Hey, let's go. It. So, you asked us for a silly dog and you asked us for a goofy dog. I believe we have matched that description.
His name is Wolfie.
Oh. And he's about 6 months old.
Oh.
Now, he's a bit of a hairy McClary. He does have a sort of rough-looking coat because he is an Irish Wolfhound mix.
Oh. So he's not full Wolfhound, so he's not going to be like that extra, extra large, huge, big boy, but it's going to be a large breed.
I'm so excited. I just can't wait.
Yeah. Do you want to meet him?
Yeah, we can't wait.
All right. Great. Let's do it.
Let's do this.
Having a dog to greet us will be the ultimate dream.
Oh, honey, this is so good.
You know, the Australian dream is the house, but with us, it's not complete without the dog.
Wow. That's so cool.
All right, let's go.
Hello. Good boy. Wolfie is an Irish Wolfhound. He's under a year old, loves his food, loves his treats. So he's quite energetic, loves a good run around in the yard as well and just being a big goofball.
Wow.
So poor Wolfie, he didn't have the best start to life, but now he's healthy and happy. Looking for someone that can just put a lot of time into him because he is a miracle boy. Good boy.
Good job.
after being surrendered to the AWL with his lifelong friend Chai.
Let's go. I know.
11-year-old schmoodle Poochie is facing hard times.
His hips are very stiff. Yeah, they're pretty much not moving. Yeah.
Unfortunately, when Poochie came in, we've done a medical assessment on him. Possibly looks like he does have something quite terminal, which unfortunately for Poochie, it's not something where we could rehire him because we're not sure how long he's got left.
He's got a very large lump on the back of his head, which we've already taken samples of, and it is unfortunately, it does seem to be a cancer.
So an animal who we know might not have long, but is quite okay at the moment, we'll put him into palliative care, meaning they'll be in a foster home until, unfortunately, they pass away.
There we go. Even more handsome now. Okay.
Chai and Poochie came in together. You know, it's very hard for us to break up dogs who have lived together for such a long time, but we don't want to hold off another animal who can be in a loving home like Chai. So that's why we've made a decision to split Poochie and Chai up.
Are you hiding?
Yeah, you are. We'll be fine.
Our goal was always to have someone with a dog. Boy, he's such a good boy. Come on. And for Valentina, it's the right time. Best friend.
Oh my god. Hi.
Oh, wow. Can't believe that's a puppy.
Look at his tail.
Hello.
Wow.
Yeah, we might keep him on the lead just until they're comfortable.
That's okay. No worries.
Oh, look how good he is. Look.
Boy.
Do you mind if I bring him over?
Yeah.
Well, they look a little bit nervous, don't they?
Oh, beautiful.
Please.
It's all right. He just wants to smell you. Just put your legs down like mummy.
No, I don't want it to jump on me.
No, he won't. If you be calm, we'll teach you. Be calm. When you're ready.
No, I don't.
Hi, gorgeous. Nah. Sit down.
Good boy.
See, look. I don't have any more. It's okay. Ginny's all right. I think it's the jumping they're not used to. Well, don't be scared.
He's not gonna bite. Don't worry.
They did say the girls are quite standoffish at first, but then once they can pat the dog, they're fine.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
We just need a bit of a wolfy snuggle.
I don't know what to do, honey.
I don't know. I'm just too scared.
I think I might just go and have a chat with them.
Yeah,
I think that's
probably a good idea.
I don't know what to do.
That's not my dog. He wouldn't bark like that.
He sounds big.
Did you say I'm going to be the godmother?
You are going to be the godmother. Yes.
Looking forward to being your godmother.
We'll have to have a godmother party.
A doggy shower.
Supported by best friend Christine is the vibrant and optimistic Chez.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you? I'm doing splendid. How are you two doing?
Really good.
I'm really excited, especially this girl.
She's my baby.
Hey. So my name is Viola.
Yeah, I'm Chris.
Chris,
yeah. And I'm Chez.
Chez.
Short for Cheryl, but it's Chez.
I would describe Chez as a colourful planet, and she's got this gravitational pull, and it pulls people in.
Oh.
And they all love her.
Oh, it's lovely. I'd love to meet you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, stop it.
Beautiful.
Go. Get away from me.
Okay,
I'm
going to blush. Okay.
Yeah, she's a special girl.
Okay, we'll sit here. How's that?
Yeah.
I think this is lovely.
Oh, my gosh.
You guys. But, hey, you know what? It's okay. It's all right.
So hard to match rescues with kids. They think jumping up's aggressive, whereas for Wolfie, it's, hi, this is how I say hello.
Yeah.
We've been wanting this for a very long time.
But I need my kids to be happy. I can't have my kids unhappy just to make me happy. That's not the way parenting works.
Yeah.
Hey guys, hey guys. My name's Sam, one of the shelter managers here at AWL. Obviously the girl's a little bit upset. So if you two want to go outside, and then we'll keep Jack with Valentina in here.
Yeah.
Do a slow introduction. I can have a proper chat.
Yeah.
And show what we can do to, to approach the dog. And then
let's try that.
We want to set it up for success. If fewer people, it's generally more successful.
Divide and conquer.
Yeah.
What we'll do, we'll keep him distracted with Rao. And then come and say hello.
You go when you're ready, okay? I'll go with you.
And I'll stay here with you, okay. so I've got hold of him, okay? I've got hold of his collar.
See? Nothing's going to happen.
You're being very brave, doing a really good job.
All right, there we go. Look, this Donnie's back here. There you go. Look, while I'm doing it.
He's nice and soft. He's had a bath, so he's nice and clean too.
There we go, you did it.
You're nice and soft, he is. I see a smile coming out.
Hey. You did it. You're so brave.
She did well. She gave him a pat.
That's very brave.
Now she's going to go in again, hopefully.
Boy, Wolfie.
Very brave. Good job, Valentina.
Okay. Loves it.
Do you want to give him a treat?
All right, wait a little bit.
Yeah, that's fine.
Oh, that's okay.
Oh, you're okay.
Just a bit scared of him.
I'm not. But you look how brave you've been.
We came here today to get a dog, but if it takes a little bit more time, then that's okay.
Obviously, we're not going to pressure them into doing something that they're not comfortable with.
What are your honest thoughts?
My selfish side is beautiful. My other side says I've got to look after them. At the end of the day, we have to decide what's right for our family and make sure that they're okay with the dog as well.
Another doggy.
I just feel bad for that dog.
Oh, no, it's okay.
It was a bit hard, I think.
Yeah. Sorry, Wolfie. I know. I'm sorry.
But that one's probably sad now.
Why is he sad?
Because he hasn't performed,
but he's just not the right one for us. But let's see.
He could have been.
He could have
been scared.
Friend to help her find a new one is the ever smiling Chez.
You guys look amazing today. You're very colourful.
Oh, thank you.
Yes.
Hey. It matches my hair.
It does match your hair. Indeed. Yes, it does.
So, you guys friends?
They're good friends.
Yeah, really good friends. Yeah. And I'm just here to help Chez, you know, get a little companion.
Moral support.
And I'm here to look for a baby for me. I've been retired since I was about 55. Yeah, my husband retired at 50, so about the same age as me. So I lost him almost 12 months now, which is the next month. So just need some companion. I just need a little fur baby at home to keep me company. Yeah, we've been together for 50 years. That's a bit sad. And I've been really sort of just wanting a bit of company, but I wasn't ready. But now I'm ready with all the support of my friends, and that's what I'm looking forward
to.
When he passed away, Chris and I were talking, she said, you've got to get a dog, Chez, you know, you need a dog, because I sit at home of a night time and it's just so lonely. I can't describe it. There's nothing there, you know, and I sort of put my hand where I used to sit sort of thing, and it's just, I need something sitting here with me.
So do you have any, I guess, favourite breeds?
One of those little...
There's so many choices.
Little thing like that.
Yeah. So maybe like Chihuahua, Terriers.
Yeah.
Poodles. Yeah, poodles, anything like that. Just something I can pick up.
Yep.
Something cute. It sort of looks like it's smiling, you know.
Yeah.
Come to coffee and lunch, of course.
Okay. Yeah. Social, so it needs to be social.
Yeah, got a social dog, definitely. Yeah.
So some might just take a while to
That's
come
fine.
Around.
More Is that... prepared for that.
And you've got lots of patience.
I have got a lot of patience.
Yeah, and kindness.
Perfect.
This is really important to us.
It is. It is
for
important.
You know, she's got a beautiful circle of friends.
Me being one. Yes.
But, you know, it's those times when you wave goodbye and, you know, Chez is on her own.
I know.
Yeah. Oh, God, we have to stop blubbering. No, he'll have a lovely home.
Oh, beautiful.
So yeah, I just can't wait.
All right, well, how about you let Jules and I go have a little chat with our manager?
Yeah, please.
Right.
Good luck.
No problem.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you so much.
So, Shaz is 73 years old and she's just looking for a companion.
Oh, yeah. Nice. So she lost her for her. Yeah.
Is there any breed preference?
She did mention like chihuahuas or poodles or little terriers. Yeah. I think any breed that's small, confident and social.
Yeah. And we do have Olive.
Oh my goodness. Well, Olive, she's a dissex female mini foxy cross. She'd be a dog that needs inside access. I think she'd get plenty of inside access in this home.
Yes.
She can be a little bit shy, so it'll take a bit of warming up for her, but she's a sweet cutie pie and she's the perfect lap dog.
Yeah, she's sweet.
Yeah.
Olive would be a great option.
Yeah.
What about as another option, little Yoga?
She is super cute. She's a wide-haired Jack Russell cross.
Yeah.
Foxy, maybe?
Yeah.
So she can be quite timid at first. So she does take, she's another one, takes a while to warm up. She's a delicate little lady. And her favorite things are food, patient people, and gentle.
So, Courtney, cool, you did assessments on both Yoga and Olive.
Yeah.
In your opinion, who would be better suited for Shaz?
It would really, to me, come down to the dog sociability.
Mm.
And we know that Olive has done some parallel walks here with a few dogs, where Yoga's kind of hasn't had that experience.
So in that case, then we'll lean more towards Olive. And you know, Olive, when she does get comfortable with you, she is a really sweet dog. So
she is.
Just, something we have to tell Shaz and Chris that, you know, she's going to take a little time.
Yeah.
But, you know, trust in the process and she will be a really good dog for you.
Yeah, definitely.
Olive it is.
All right.
Olive it is.
Sorry for the wait.
That's so nice.
Okay.
We have found you a lovely little girl.
She's a little mini foxy cross.
Oh my gosh.
Sounds good.
Oh, that sounds name is Olive.
Olive.
Oh,
yes.
That is
so cute.
Yeah.
So she's super playful once she gets to know you. She loves jumping up on you. She loves pats and cuddles.
That's what I want.
Yeah. Just when she first meets you, she's just going to be a little bit timid.
That's okay. Yeah. I mean, we've got to get to know each other. So we've got plenty of time.
Yeah. Exactly right.
All right, you guys ready to meet her?
Yeah.
All right,
let's go.
Oh, my gosh.
Amazing.
Best of luck. See you. Thank you so much. It's been lovely to talk to you. Robin and my husband, we're like that, always together. Yeah, so when he passed, I was with him. It's going to change my life.
Yep.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's going to just change my life. It really is. A lot of people say, oh, you know, I'd find someone else. There's no way. If I can just get a little dog, I'll have the love that I need. And that's what I want.
Oh my goodness. Here today we have Olive. She's a mini foxy mix and we've estimated her at about 3 years old. She came to us from a rural facility where unfortunately they were over capacity.
Come on, baby bean.
Oh, such a good girl. A lot of the dogs that come through shelter do present signs of anxiety, including our lovely Olive. The way we combat that is giving them lots of enrichment.
Good girl, there you go.
Oh, yum. So Olive loves her licky mats. That's one of her things that really calms her down and gives her something to kind of focus all that energy on.
Good girl.
In the time that she's been here, she's grown so much in confidence. So she does need a little bit of time, a little bit of patience. But once you kind of form that bond with her, she's such a great little companion.
Puppy, come on, Olive.
Oh. Oh my gosh, let's go. Come on.
Shut up.
Oh my gosh, Shazzy.
Good.
Oh my gosh. Oh.
Hi, guys.
Hi.
Oh, darling.
I think Shazzy's a little bit shocked.
Yeah. This is Olive.
Oh, how are you,
she can
darling.
Be a little bit shy at first, so I'll get
it's
you
okay.
To sit there for a moment.
Hello, honey bun. Hello,
she's
honey bun.
Amazing.
She's kissing you too. Look, hello, you beautiful little
dog's going.
Oh, she's pretty confident.
Yeah, she just went straight up to them, hey, as soon as Cody walked towards them.
It was really cute.
You guys are all good to go.
Thank you.
Amazing.
Oh, thank you.
Capital T. Interesting how to see what Olive does now. Cody walks
up. Now that Cody's gone.
Will she realise?
Oh, wait!
Thank you. Oh, baby. What happened? Let's go. Olive. Come on, Olive. Come on. Come on, Olive. Let's go, baby.
Yeah, at the moment, Cody's struggling to leave. I think Olive's going to definitely change behavior once she does.
Yes.
While she's distracted, I'm going to slip out.
That's fine.
All right, I'll be just outside the door, guys.
Yep. We'll take care of her.
There you go. That's good. Come on, Angel.
I'm investigating.
Olive!
She'll be alright.
Yeah.
We'll just give her a bit of time.
Come on. Olive! Olive! Come here. Come here. Come on.
She is doing like the 360 spins that looks like they're trying to chase her tail, but I think back to self.
Yeah.
Yeah. Poor little thing. She's just so unsure.
I know. She's not sure what's going on. Come on, baby. Come on, baby. Come on. Come on.
Oh, regurge. She must be stressed. Poor thing.
If she's that stressed.
If she's that stressed, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh.
Welcome to AWL. Come right in.
Arriving with their hearts filled with hope for finding a canine companion are the ever-determined Bennetts, along with carers Linda and Georgia.
Hello, guys.
Hey, how are you?
Not too bad. So my name is Viola, and who have we got today?
Laurel, which means peace. But there's nothing peaceful about me, so I think I was wrongly named. His name is Darrell. And it's the crazy time sometimes. You'll speak to me later. He's being cheeky.
I'm assuming you two are married together?
Yeah, we've been married 37 years.
Wow. What do you love about him?
Sometimes. Yeah. I don't, but most of the time I
Darrell isn't talking as much as he was.
No.
So the real love story is going to be Laurel and his dog.
If I could get a dog, I would be so happy. I just want a dog so bad.
Well, you've come to the right place, and I will find you a new companion.
I'm so.
Yeah, I am sure of it. I have no doubt.
It'll be beautiful, honestly. It'll bring so much more energy to me.
Happy wife, happy life.
Yeah. I didn't think this had happened to us, did you?
Well,
I hope that this isn't turning Shaz away from Olive.
Yeah.
Olive was like this the first day with him at her. Yeah. It didn't take long for us to build a bond.
No.
I think, you know, Shaz is the perfect home for her. I think Shaz will spoil her on.
Yeah.
Just
that's
need
right.
to build that bond.
He comes to handle.
Oh, hi! Hi! Hi, guys!
Hi!
How are you going?
Oh, not real well.
Normal for her?
Yeah.
So I'll hang out in here with you guys for a little bit.
Yeah.
So as you can see, like, it does take her a while to kind of adjust to new
things. Yeah, that's okay.
She was exactly like that with me when she first arrived as well.
She's got a little spring in her step again.
Yeah. Instant change. Oh, look at that.
Yeah. Hi. Oh, my goodness.
Look at that.
Yeah. She's very sweet.
She is lovely.
She's got so much potential.
You know, I think this is a prime example of the dogs who come into our care on certain ones, and they're timid and scared that, yeah, they're never going to have that instant bouncy meet and greet. These are the ones who we need someone like Shez to come through our door who are quite standard.
Yeah.
Hi, baby bean.
Come, walkies.
Hi, come here.
It's a whole new start for the dog, and hopefully a new start for me.
And once she doesn't see Cody, maybe she'll love us then. Maybe she'll love me.
Good walking. How's everyone feeling today? Excited?
Excited.
Yeah? Well, welcome to Animal Welfare League, guys. And what would be your favourite dream dog?
Something about this high.
Okay.
That I can train just to sit in front of me and I can walk with safety, that I'm not going to run over. I've had cerebral palsy ever since I was born. There's nothing wrong with my mental state, it's physical. And my husband, he also has cerebral palsy. I'm really desperate to get something. I'm very open to what it is.
The thing with Darrell's speech, as he's sort of gotten older, the muscles aren't quite the same as what they used to be. Has deteriorated probably the last year. And it doesn't happen for everybody. Everybody has different reactions. Like, I mean, look at Laurel. They're the same age. She speaks perfectly clear.
She does say she's a bit lonely at the moment and she's been wanting a dog for 18 months.
Yeah.
She's wanting
the companionship. You know, who am I going to talk to? And I think having the dog there will help. Mm.
So how did you two meet?
Yeah. see that finger?
Yeah.
The shape of it.
Is he holding it up?
He sat on it and broke it. And I had to feed him because he couldn't feed himself.
Oh.
So that's where that broke.
Finger.
And I said to my mother, there's no way I'll ever marry that jerk. And look what happened.
37 years later.
That's brilliant. Well, guys, thank you so much for chatting to us. We'll be back very, very shortly.
The part you're waiting for, Laurel.
Okay.
I've been praying.
Oh, thank you, guys.
Thanks, guys.
Bye.
Yeah, she's very, very excited. I think if we walk out there with nothing, she's going to cry.
Oh, so. Of course, yeah.
We've got to find something today.
Yeah, it's an interesting challenge, but it's something hopefully we can match up. What are you guys thinking?
Look, I'd love to place a greyhound.
Yeah.
Especially with them, I think it's a great idea. So we've got a couple of greyhounds, one of which is Kelly. She's a real quirky little monster.
Yeah, she's got one
So Kelly came into AWL with four other ex-racing greyhounds from a regional area. They were brought in by the inspectors due to neglect.
You think she's a puppy sometimes. She'll do like full finger rounds, like throw the ball for herself, everything.
And does she calms down pretty well though, doesn't she?
She does, yeah.
She is going through some medical things, so I wonder if she's actually right yet.
Kelly is undergoing treatment to heal her legs after having grass seeds in her paws.
Right, she's still got the bandage and the booty and everything on her
she's
feet.
She's still got her feet.
Yeah.
We do have potentially Chai.
Look at that nose.
He's so cute.
So Chai is 10 years old and he is a Labrador. He was surrendered with another dog, Poochie, who he has been living with most of his life. That's so sad. Is he going to be okay going without Poochie though?
He unfortunately has some severe medical issues, which will potentially go into palliative care.
So he's about to lose his little mate.
Yeah. Chai's a pretty good option. He's good to calm down. He's a pretty well-mannered dog. He has a bit of energy. He'll go for a run and whatnot, and then come back and go, oh, I just want to sit with you and have a bit of a pat. I think Chai's the best option.
I think so.
You know, it was a bit of a challenge, but I think we've gotten pretty close.
He's that beautiful, calm, really gentle nature that you guys are looking for.
So he is a Labrador.
Oh my God.
And his name is Chai.
Can you tell me what the story is?
Yeah, so he was surrendered to us because his owner had to unfortunately leave to go overseas.
Will you tell that person that I will look after him?
Oh, I will.
There you go.
Lovely, guys.
Oh, man.
I know, she's making me upset. God, Laurel, stop. Would you please?
Bloody hell. See, though, honestly, someone that's already this invested in a dog that you haven't even met, like, it's really beautiful.
He wants to take you, people.
Take what?
Everybody that...
Thank you to everybody.
Oh, thank you. So how are we feeling? Are we excited? We're ready to meet Chai?
Yes.
Let's do it.
Wait.
Let's try. Dogs can love you unconditionally. They ask for nothing back but to be loved.
Okay, let's go.
They're non-judgmental. They're not like some humans on this earth that can be judgmental.
Hi, baby. Hello, sweetheart.
This is beautiful Chai. Chai is a 10-year-old Labrador cross.
This way, sweetheart. Come on. Good boy.
So Chai was an owner surrender. Unfortunately, his owners had to go overseas to look after a sick family member.
Good work, Chai. Good boy.
He doesn't need to go out for a massive run. He just needs someone that's happy to have a low-key buddy. It'd be really lovely to see him just with an older couple that's happy to go for a very slow walk and then let him have his naps at home and give him all the cuddles he deserves. It's hard not to fall in love with him, really. Yeah, he's just one of the best dogs.
Good boy.
Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness.
Boy, let's go. Ready?
Oh my god.
Here you go.
Look. Oh my god.
Future baby. Laurel and Darrell are waiting to be introduced to distinguished gent Chai, the surrendered Labrador.
Go back. Already?
The shelter's no place for any dog, let alone an old dog. It's so hard for them being...
Oh my goodness.
Look.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. He's adorable.
Oh,
oh, hi, this God. Is Chai.
Hi, Chai.
Hi.
Oh, good boy. Oh, he's such a handsome
puppy. So, guys, are you comfortable if I let him off lead?
Yeah.
No worries.
Thank you very much for your help.
No worries.
What do you think?
Come on, beautiful boy.
Hi, Chai.
Hello.
Hello.
Come on. Yeah. Hi. You're beautiful.
Hi, Laurel.
Hi, Darrell.
Oh, look at him.
That's cute. He's got the windmill tail going.
He does.
He's a good boy.
Oh, he's lovely.
Chai. Oh, he's a lovely boy.
Chai. Brownie, mate. Hey, Jim.
Hey.
Beautiful boy. Yes, you are. Chai. Well, what is he? I really love Darrell. Men wouldn't swap him for anything. We have moments like everybody else, but we never let the sun get down on our anger if we can help him. Yeah, I let him have sniff. Yeah. We fought too hard to get married, and we've been through so much. My mum went to the government to get them to change the law. Nobody was allowed to marry because it was under nursing home rule.
It was something to do with you both having a disability, I think, from memory, from what you told me before, Laurel.
But we finally got there. It was a hideous day. It was as cold as anything. And it was raining. But as we came out of church, the sun came out, so I reckon there was God shining on us, saying yes.
Chai!
We're taking him home, honey.
Chai!
He likes me.
Chai!
And I realise that things are not the same as they used to be, but I still love him more than ever.
He likes you, Darrell.
Hey!
Yeah. He definitely loves Darrell, that's for sure.
Look, he does. He likes Darrell a lot.
He's talking to him, hey. Uh-oh, what if he's the favourite?
Oh, no, that's not going to be allowed, I don't think.
Nope.
Look, he loves
boy. You've got a son.
Look, he's even lying down.
He likes Darrell.
Maybe it might take a bit of getting used to me, I don't know.
Oh, look at that.
Oh, darling.
It is bittersweet because Chai is going to have to leave Poochie behind.
It sucks.
It does. In saying that, though, I mean, the beautiful thing about animals is the concept of time is not something that they really understand. So as far as he knows, he might see Poochie tomorrow. Mm.
Goodbye. Do you love me? Darrell, stop moving around. I'm trying to get him to...
Hey, he's going to jump on the back with you now, Darrell.
I think he's in love. Oh, geez. Whoa, big jump for a big boy.
Hey,
wow.
Here he is, Laurel.
Hey. Hello.
Here you go, Laurel. He's on your shoulder.
Hi, Chai. See how big he is.
Look, there he is.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi. Can I take you home?
What do you think, Chai?
You got it, Laurel?
I got it, but...
Oh, there he goes.
Good boy. That was what you were waiting for.
You got it. I think that was what I wanted him to do.
Oh my God. You are a beautiful boy.
Look at him.
Yes, you are. You want to come home with me?
Oh, don't cry. It's happy times.
It's happy teeth.
You want more? I don't think so. You'll be a fat dog.
You get so many people that are like so specific with what they have to have and the looks and personality. Like it has to be perfect. Like she's been in there for not even 10 minutes and she's already in love with him. Like just to see him for what he is.
Chai. Oh, that sounded more like Chai.
Hey, there you go.
Hey.
I think it's a very sweet match. Again.
Do you love him, though? You can't not take him. Please. I get blown away in a minute. No, did you just say blown away? I hope not. I couldn't wait to meet a dog. Chai, he went to Darrell first. And then he came over to me, and I just thought he was the perfect dog for me. But I was worried that he might be a little bit strong for me. I can't hold him in my hand, but we worked it out. He does not act like 10-year-old.
Oh, okay, that's right.
Yeah, let's go back.
The other day, raced him up the road.
Darrell!
Forget about him.
He's taken her over on the outside.
He's got a lot more energy than he makes that he's got. You're a good boy. Chai. I think he's asleep. I like Chai because he was so gentle to us. that happened to me. You're a big talk. Look at you. He is the perfect dog for me.
And me.
And Darrell said, and me.
When Wolfie first came out, I wasn't ready for how big he would be, because they did say a puppy.
I thought, wow, what is this majestic creature that's come out? And then I looked down to the kids and I thought, uh-oh.
Dalmatian.
Oh, look at the Dalmatian. That's beautiful.
I didn't think they would get as scared as they did. That was a surprise. What unfolded was not what we expected
at all. The look of fear in their eyes sort of made me really worried.
I was trying to warm up to him, but I was still scared, so I couldn't really do it.
Oh, look at
I thought, nah, that's it. No dog. But I said, no. I know that we'll warm up to him. Let's do it.
Wolfie! Wolfie! Hey, boy. Hey, sit. Valentina, she actually cried. She said, I really want to give Wolfie a go. I want to take him home.
I didn't want him to stay there. I thought he would want to live with us and be a part of our family.
He is the biggest, goofy, just amazing dog. He's so lovable.
What does he do?
Roll off his bed.
Yeah, he rolls off his bed. Oh, yeah. Good job. Look at that smile.
Just watching them grow, overcome their fears, it's a great lesson for both of them.
The leaders of the pack. You're growing taller, Timmy.
Finally. I'm so happy that we bring him home. If we didn't bring him home, I would never get over my fears. And I love him, and it's just really good. Sit.
Oh, good boy. Perfect.
Good boy.
Next time on The Doghouse.
Dog out!
Rusty the Red Kelpie is everything this family has dreamed of.
Ego!
Oh my God!
But will he be too much of a good thing?
Rusty?
Hold yourself.
Just turn around.
While other big-hearted dogs try to find the fairy tale ending. For the loved up.
We're just at that moment, aren't we? We're just ready to add to the family.
And the down on their luck.
Oh, no.
Ha ha.